Over the past few weeks, several people have filed police reports after becoming the victims of a pet scam. Local experts tell us these types of scams have been on the rise since the start of the pandemic. KLBK's Grace Morris, you've been following these scams. How exactly do they work?
Pet scams usually happen when someone posts a photo of a dog or a cat that they say they're selling, but in reality, they don't actually have the pet. Once you send them the money, the pet scammers disappear. But there are a few simple tricks that can help you avoid these.
It all starts with social media.
Finding a furry friend.
It goes from posting this cute, fluffy dog that everybody wants.
Isn't always as easy as it seems.
What they'll do is they'll ask for a rehoming fee.
Especially with pet scams on the rise.
They'll find a way to get the money wired over, and then after that, there's no puppy.
According to Pete Ortiz with the Lubbock Animal Shelter and Elizabeth Randolph with Operation Paw Prints, these types of scams involving animals are happening more and more in the Lubbock area.
I keep trying to explain to people, that picture you see, that could be anybody's picture. That's probably a real picture, but these people are probably some scammers in some other country.
In 2020, the Better Business Bureau received around 4,000 complaints nationwide of pet-related scams, up from under 2,000 in 2019. Scammers will often post about certain breeds for lower prices than a breeder might ask for, drawing many folks to ask about the dog. Both Ortiz and Randolph believe that this is another reason these scams are becoming so popular.
It definitely draws in the right people, especially when it's over a cute dog or the dog that everybody wants. Of course, everybody's going to hit. So it's an easy way just to pretty much make a dollar off anybody.
But both say while these scams can be hard to spot, simply checking the seller's profile and doing some research can help you avoid these types of scams.
Do your homework. Like if you want to get a certain breed, Google it. Know what that breed is supposed to be like. Ask for the papers. Ask for health records on the parents. You know, if it sounds too good to be true, it's not true.
Both experts say that the best thing to do if to hope that you're not going to be scammed is to ask the seller to see the animal in person or over video before sending them any money and to try and avoid sending money over the internet.